What do you think about an outright ban on student cell phones in public schools? At least one lawmaker thinks it makes more sense to do that than spend $181 million to incentivize school districts to prevent students from using their phones in the classroom. With more details on that, we're joined by our Capitol correspondent, Jason Doyle, at our OETA studio inside of the Capitol. Jason.
Rich, the Senate Education Committee took up legislation this week to set up a program incentivizing schools to ban cell phones in the classroom. And that's when the idea was floated for an outright ban. While lawmakers are wrestling with the issue, school districts are finding ways to deal with it now. It's lunchtime for students at the middle school of Piedmont, and the kids are enjoying a little social time with their phones in hands. But are they a distraction in the classroom?
We had seen a pretty big increase in distraction. Students just losing focus as to what was going on in the classroom. So we decided last year to go with the statement of silent and away.
Students are still allowed to use the phones when not in the classroom.
We do allow them to get to use them in their common time during passing period and at lunch and before and after school. But we just ask that during that instructional time that it's put away.
So far, the policy seems to have worked for the middle school.
It just was unusual for them and something new. So we had some adjustment time at the beginning of last year. But this year, they just accepted it and they follow suit. It's pretty easy for them just to, they've had that opportunity for 5 minutes while they've walked around.
So tell me, how many students do you have here at the middle school?
We have just under 800, about 780 students at this point.
Middle school principal Aaron Pruitt knows how to deal with distractions. Right now, the final touches are happening to the new school being built right next to the current buildings.
We are having a great year, and we have overcome a lot of things with tractors and dirt and construction and all of the things that happen. But, you know, it's been great that we've still been able to do school regardless of what's happening outside. What happens inside of our classroom hasn't changed.
Over at Piedmont High School, students use their phones as part of certain assignments. These students were identifying items in Spanish with their phones and laptops.
Now, if the teachers are using them for a lesson, they can get them out. And a lot of teachers do incorporate cell phones for different type of activities and stuff because they can be helpful. I mean, they are a tool in certain ways.
Piedmont High School Principal Steve Spears says this campus put a silent away cell phone policy into place a few years ago. While the policy has worked overall here, Spears acknowledges that cell phones are an issue.
They have been a distraction, and it depends on how the school handles it and how the teachers handle it and do they get support from the administration. Teachers compete against cell phones for student engagement, student attention. Our teachers do a great job here, and our kids are really compliant. They understand, and we don't have a lot of cell phone discipline issues here in the classroom.
On Tuesday, the Senate Education Committee considered that very issue, how to help schools handle cell phones in the classroom. Committee Chairman Adam Pugh is proposing a $181 million incentive program to help schools eliminate that electronic distraction.
I want schools to know that this body is paying attention to cell phone use. I've heard from teachers and parents, and everybody is trying to tackle this issue.
Pugh says a superintendent convinced him that something needed to be done because it's impacted students' performance in some schools.
I got a phone call from a superintendent in eastern Oklahoma, a small school, who took over a school that he described as a C school when he first got there. His first order of business, this was over a decade ago, was to ban cell phones. He said there was quite a bit of pushback initially, and he thought the school board was going to fire him. He turned his school from a C to an A.
The incentive program does carve out exceptions for students who need their phones for medical reasons. Pugh also noted that the price tag for the incentive program isn't a set figure.
I just want to keep this in the front of our brains. If you all vote this down because of the fiscal impact, I understand. I do. I've thought a million ways about how do I incentivize? We could just ban cell phones, which may be where we get to.
That idea of just banning phones from the classroom began to catch hold among committee members.
If parents choose to send their children to a government school, then they should assume that that government school, to best degree, is going to give best practice. And so then I think many of us have talked about local control, and local decision-making and parental decision-making, but some of those we also affirm rise above the level of local and are universals.
Three other senators also called for an outright ban on phones in the classroom instead of an incentive program. However, the momentum for the incentive program continued.
I think this is a great step forward, not just for the conversation, but we have to start talking about the correlation not only with the deterioration of social skills, soft skills in our workforce and things like that, the detriment to our young kids, but there is a very clear connection between smartphone usage and educational attainment.
Despite being a distraction in the classroom, some parents want their children to have the phones in case an emergency happens. Piedmont High School Principal Steve Spears says his school's current policy covers that too.
As far as any type of emergency, I mean, again, the kids have their cell phones, so trust me, they're contacting their parents.
Middle School of Piedmont Principal Aaron Pruitt says a lot of the distraction attributed to cell phones is actually caused by social media.
I would say that that is the biggest impact that cell phones have within our middle school setting, are the things that are occurring on social media, typically outside of the school day, before school, after school, weekends, that bleed into the disruption of our school day.
The Senate Education Committee did pass Pugh's bill, and it's now eligible to be heard on the Senate floor. Rich?
Jason, thank you.